for me. About a car length back to me, and another 3.5 past me to the tail of the track. Patiently waiting at the tail end of the track. Believe it or not, in here having a light truck, and then slow is actually a good thing. They're probably going to get within about 10 feet of the stop. Going to the low power mode right now. He's probably less than a car length from the tail of the track now. Probably less than half a car length. Next to the dial corner. Okay. They already pulled out all the empty vessels with the blinking light up on the main line there. And the tail of the last empty that was on the tail of my track. There were three other empties, so there's four empties sitting up there between that tail of that and the switch. And of course, my cars are that are being delivered are being pushed down the switch. It looks like he's got more up there on the head. I bet he's going to Mitsubishi after it goes here, because it looks like it's coming top of cars from here. I know it's kind of hard to tell in the dark, and it's darker on the video than it is. At least I can see the shadow of the shape of the cars up there, even from this side of the car. All right, I'm not going to hook anything up until my air brake cuts off for safety. And that'll probably still be about another 5 minutes. He's got to tie down his brake wheel. In fact, stay on. Keep the video running just for another minute. Maybe you hear him tying down a brake wheel or two. Beyond that, not a lot of interest either. The sounds of but he tied him down the started listening to it. He tied him down there. Maybe I'll hold on and listen to that brake hose pop off it. That's what I want to hear before I touch it. Just safety first, because you know, that brake line pops off the cars to move a little. As they pull the cut bar and pull off. Every once in a while you'll be surprised by how much they move. Had it, you get in the habit of seeing them move a certain amount and you think, well, that's about how much they move, but no. Then there'll be a time they'll really move a good jump 4 or 5 feet, or you know, maybe once in a while you'll have it where it doesn't even break loose like it's supposed to. They catch it, start pulling the cars back out. I've certainly seen that before too. So safety first, folks. It's 13:30. This may end up going over 15 minutes, just giving him time to get up to his locomotive and make sure he's ready to pull out. So not the most thrilling video. You see it got a good bit darker with the cars pulled in. You can see all that grass before. Now it's pretty much just the light is on the gravel and would be on any passing rail cars. That light blinking didn't start blinking until about the time that train pulled by. I think the sensor in it can go several hours without starting to blink like that, but once it starts blinking like that, it'll blink for a long time. Sometimes it'll blink all the way to morning, but it's also time to come back in the morning before dawn, and it is stop blinking at some point. Just depends on how how the light reflects back into the light sensor. About 10 seconds to 15 minutes, it shouldn't be too long from pulling out. Hear the air hose pressurized. There we go. Alright, didn't even move at all. I can see their cars pulling out down there. And they're probably too dark for you to make out anything on the video. They're kind of a whitish blob receding into the distance. Looks like a covered hopper car, so. That's it for this video. Bye for now.